very good.
Very good price. So many cheap things.
But sometimes
there's a problem, like sometimes...
They are question. I don't believe them.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes from eBay I order something and it's broken. And I just think, it's okay if sometimes it's broken because everything is so cheap. I kind of expect maybe 1 in every 10 to be broken. You know what I mean? Yeah, but then you might have to post it back to them, and sometimes I just feel like, forget it, it's not worth the effort. You know, like if you spend €5 buying a USB key or something, and you have to spend €3 to post it back.
They can bid them. Bid.
You can bid, yeah.
Yeah. It's more cheaper than you buy.
Yes. Yeah. And yeah. Okay. So like I said, we'll do one lesson and then we'll work on the physics
lab report.
Yeah. I know you do. Yeah.
See.
Ah, it's okay. It's fine. Good weekend?
Yes.
My friend came from Malaysia.
Oh, great.
To visit.
Great.
And we went to the zoo.
Nice.
And the beach.
I see you were
nice.
The barbecue. Zoo.
Nice. Where? Where?
Near the place we...
Near College Green. Oh, Pittsburgh. They look good. Every time I pass them on the bus, I think...
Yes.
I think they look so good.
Every time I pass, I smell so good.
Yes.
And I smell it for months, and I can't wait.
You can't wait. Yeah. And was it good?
Better than I thought.
Better than you thought. Great. Then maybe we should all go sometime.
Yes. Karen. Mm. Yes. Trust me, 100%. Here. It's really good.
Do you know where this place is, Sophie?
Yes. We Googled it.
Oh, you went together. And what did you think? Did you like it?
Yes.
It's good?
Yes. We ordered 3 meats something.
3 meats?
Four. Bacon.
Pizza. Bacon?
Bacon.
Oh, brisket, yeah.
And if you... Yes. There are some. Both here, but under here is all of them.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
And free ice cream.
Free ice cream?
Yeah.
Why free ice cream? Because it was sunny. So now this is number one place in Dublin. Yes? Number one.
And it's not so good every time I pass through.
Great. Okay. Maybe at the end of the year we'll all go and Andy says you'll pay. Yeah. Alright, so now we finished last time the materials. So now we're on to a new chapter called Fields. Fields. So this is starting with electric fields. Yep. Okay. Right, so you know from chemistry you have charge, like electron has what type of charge?
Negative.
Has a negative charge, and a proton has a positive charge. And a neutron?
Zero.
No charge, yeah. So, charge is a property of electrons, protons, and other particles. Electrons are negative, while protons are positive. But you know this from chemistry. This is basic chemistry, right? Right? Why not? It'll give me time to drink my coffee. Got that? Yeah? Okay, so you also know from chemistry that things that are negatively charged and things that are positively charged pull on each other. So you know from chemistry if this is negative and this is positive, they want to pull together. And what happens if they're... well, this is what makes electrons and protons stick together. You know, you have the proton and then you have the electron. Things that have the same charge, what happens when they have the same charge? Yeah. They push away. Positive and positive, they push away. They repel each other. This is called the law of charges. So positive likes negative, and positive doesn't like positive, and negative doesn't like negative. What Starbucks drinks do you have today? Hot chocolates? Hot chocolate? Americano?
American
sugar. And soda? Hot chocolate. Even though it's so sunny?
Yeah, life. You know? Lifestyle.
It's a lifestyle, yeah. It's an addiction.
Oh, better than
news.
The
Frappuccino
have hot
price.
Frappuccino?
Yeah. Oh, no, I don't like Frappuccino.
You don't like Frappuccino?
No.
Strawberry?
No.
Chocolate?
No.
Banana?
No. Don't like Frappuccino. Mm. No. I like milkshake, I like ice cream, I don't like Frappuccino.
But they don't
eat
in the
Starbucks. I know. It's a problem.
A half price, you know?
Maybe I'll try it, if it's half price.
In the afternoon, I think you
will
have.
Oh, well, then I won't try it.
From 3rd of May to 15th of May.
Oh.
Today is?
17th.
Is it?
Yeah.
15th.
Over yesterday. Oh, well. Okay, you got this? You don't need to write all of it. The key idea, yeah. The same they attract, opposite they attract, the same repel. Yeah? Okay. You do this in chemistry?
Mm.
Semester one? Yeah. Continue?
No.
No. Are we just waiting for Amanda? Oh, I'll give you one more sip. Maybe two. Okay. Amanda, you can always watch the video and get it. Just leave a space. Three.
No.
Two.
Give me 50 seconds.
50? I'll give you 10 more seconds. I'm so excited. Just 2 more weeks of school and then holiday. Maybe after the holiday, because that's when the September students finish. You can get a better. Yes, life is difficult. I know, life is difficult. Right, an electric field is a vector field that shows the direction. Okay, so I really, before you write that down, I need to draw something to explain this idea. Okay. Right. So, this here, this is called a, well, you know that this is a vector, don't you? Remember vector?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is called a vector field. It's many vectors, okay? And if I go to the left here as another example, so this would be a vector force field. So imagine there was a wind coming from the north. I can draw the force from the wind as lots of vectors. So there'd be some wind here, and 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 so on. But what about here?
Stop.
Yeah, it stops, doesn't it? And you see how I draw them smaller to mean less force. But then it gets bigger again. So this is called a vector force field, or just a vector field. And it shows you the direction and the size of the force at different places. So here you can see there is no force, and here there are small forces. Here there is a big force, and if you stand here is a big force, and here is a big force. So the way you can show the force is a picture like this, called a vector force field. And this is a simple example with some wind. So if you are here, you will feel a lot of force. If you are here, you will feel no force. And if you're here, you'll feel a small force. This is called a vector force field. Okay, so are we clear what this is? Yeah? So if I can go back to the definition, an electric field is a vector field that shows the direction that a very small positive charge will move. So wait, before you write that down, let me just draw something else. So if this is a small positive, for example, and this is a big negative, which way will this positive want to move? Left or right?
Right.
Up or down?
Right.
Right. So we can picture, like the wind, there's a vector force field pushing the positive to the negative. So now the definition is, an electric field is the vector field that shows the direction a very small positive charge will move when placed in the field. So this here is an example. This is the electric field. Okay, now you can write the definition down. Thank you. Yeah?
Then for the color,
well, the, yeah, the small positive to the big negative.
Is it called
that? Well, really, these are called the electric field. Okay, continue. Yeah? So, before you draw that, I'll give you a minute to draw that, but here's a good example. So you can see here, this is the electric field between a proton and an electron, or a positive and a negative. So if I have a small positive charge, and I put it, I'm trying not to draw it. Right, so if I have a small positive charge and I put it here, will it want to move towards or away?
Away.
Away. In fact, that's what these lines show you. If you put the charge here, it will move this way. And it will move around then to the negative. If I put the charge here, what will happen? It will be pushed away to infinity. So these electric field lines, they show you where a small positive charge will move. So if I put the small positive charge over there, it'll go straight to the negative. Okay? So electric field shows you where a small positive charge will move. Okay? So this is an example of a field, and I'd like you to draw this one. There are four you have to learn for the exam. This is one of them. They sometimes ask me to draw this. This is a positive-negative pair. So where is Andy? Do we know? No, no, not really. He would never fight with what's her name? Pony. Pony might fight with him, but he wouldn't fight with Pony. Yesterday, and it's too tired to come in. Does Andy drink? No. Do you know her name?
Yeah.
No.
Last night.
Okay. So he wasn't out the last night with Pony, and now he's too tired. What I just found. Somebody left this behind. I'm glad I saw that. Do you know how much this cost on eBay? 25 cents.
Wow.
25 cents!
Wow, I think more than 1 euro.
No, I got 3 or 4 of them for a euro.
Yeah, now
you
find one of them.
Yeah, I'm happy, yeah. Okay, did you draw this?
Six months.
Absolutely.
Yep. No, go all the positive.
Into negative, yeah.
Positive
to negative, yes. Okay, continue. How do you measure charge in chemistry? In chemistry?
Okay.
Yeah, but in chemistry, what do you say the charge of an electron is?
Plus
one.
You just call it one, don't you? And proton?
One.
One. So minus one and plus one, yeah?
One.
Yes? Now, we don't use those units, of course, in physics. We don't say plus one and minus one. We use something called a coulomb.
Yeah.
Coulomb is a very, very small unit. And it's the unit for charge. So first write that bit down. But maybe you remember we talked about Coulombs when we did electricity. Yes. Oh, that's the name of the system we use. Meters, kilometers. Amanda?
Yeah.
SI is the system for meters, kilograms, seconds. Whereas in America they use, you know, pounds, feet.
Oh.
I don't know. There. Look, it's America, okay? It's America. What can I say? They want to be different. Okay, so what is the definition? Well, in fact, 1 coulomb is what you get when you have 1 amp for 1 second. So 1 amp for 1 second makes 1 coulomb.
What?
1 amp. It says it here, look. 1 amp in 1 second is a coulomb. No, you look confused. So here, if you have 1 amp moving for 1 second, the total charge that moves will be 1 coulomb. Remember, because 1 amp is actually 1 coulomb per second. So a coulomb is what you get when you have 1 amp for 1 second. Yeah. Okay. So, what is that for a proton? So, a proton, which you called plus one, we now say its charge is this many coulombs. Not many. 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19 coulombs. An electron is the same, but with a minus. And a neutron is zero. Yeah. By the way, mass of a proton, you might need it for this lesson. So here's the mass of a proton. It's very small. Sorry, in chemistry, do you use the mass of a proton? Like, have you seen this number before? No. Mass of an electron, bigger or smaller? About 1,000 times smaller. And mass of a neutron is about the same as a proton. In fact, there is a small difference, but for right now they're the same. So, one sentence here at the end when you're ready. Now, you call proton plus one, and that's fine. In physics, we don't say plus one. We call the charge of a proton as plus E. But in chemistry, I know you call it plus one. But if you want, at least call it plus E. And an electron would be minus E then.
Okay.
Okay.
Wait, that plus one is plus E.
Plus E and electron is minus E. Right, different parts of the field will be stronger or weaker than other parts. After all, shouldn't this... Yeah, so if... I don't have the picture here, but if you imagine, if I put the small proton very close to... If I put the small positive charge very close to the negative charge, it will... If I let go, it will fly away quickly. But if I put it here and let go, will it move as fast? No, we kind of picture the closer it is, when I let go, it will move away faster.
The same charge,
yeah. The same charge, yeah. So if I move this closer and then let go, there'll be more force. If I have it here and let go, less force. So as I get closer, I get stronger, more force.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You kind of know this, like, you know when you have a magnet and you push the magnets together, the closer they are, the harder it is to push them. So you have the same idea here. So we have this idea called electric field strength. How strong is the field at different parts? So where should it be the strongest?
When it's touching,
when it's very, very close. And where should it be the weakest? When it's very far away, yeah. And there's a formula for electric field strength. The electric field strength, E, is as a formula, the force it feels divided by its charge. So if it's very close, there's a big force, and that means the electric field strength will be very big. So it's the force per unit charge. It's how much force you have per unit positive charge. Charge. Yeah, continue. Okay. What are the units for E?
Newton per Coulomb.
Correct. Newton per Coulomb.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Finished?
No.
Finish your copy? Oh, good. Right, continue. So, let's have a look at our first question then. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. No, just 4. Only 4. Okay.
Only 4.
Only 4. 4 questions, examples. Yeah, so write down the first one. I never said the distance. But I don't need to.
the world meaning of the insulated?
Uninsulated means that the the metal,
metal
has no plastic on it.
Ah.
It's unprotected.
Unprotected?
Unprotected, not protected.
Yeah.
Very dangerous.
No
plastic cover, no protection. Yes? Okay, can I do this one?
Yes.
Yep. Actually, just before I do it, remember earlier I said E is 1.67 times 10 to the minus 19, was it?
Yeah.
Minus 19 coulombs.
Yeah.
Yeah. And do you remember what the, wasn't it?
1.602.
Oh, 602. Well, yeah, minus power.
Yeah, that's
correct. And do you remember what the mass of a proton was? It was 1.66?
1.67.
10 to the 27.
Minus 27.
Yeah, of course. Minus 27. Ridiculous. I forgot to say, but often we call this number here, to save time, we call this number here just U. So, for example, a proton, its mass we say is 1U and its charge is plus 1E. And this would be kilograms and coulombs. So, I'm just saying, if you see this here, 1U, it just means this one. That's something we'll talk about again later. But if you see it, that's all it means. Yeah. Okay. Can I do the question now? Yeah? So, what you have here, it's actually a simple question. You have the copper wire, and there's a positive charge in it. And this causes an electric field. And here there is an electron. You are 100% correct. Thank you for noticing my mistake. How embarrassing. Right, and then there's an electron here. And the electron will get pulled towards the positive. I know it looks weird because when I did it, we had a positive inside the field. The negative moves the opposite direction to the field. Right, so we know the strength here. The strength is, what did I say? It was 10 to the minus 20. Oh, sorry, you can't see it up there. Oh, those are positive symbols, not X's, sorry. 10 to the minus 25 newtons per coulomb. And you have your formula E equals F over Q. So F equals EQ. So the F will equal...
Where'd you get that value E equals?
This? Yeah. What's the charge of an electron? 1.602, wasn't it?
602.
Two? Charge of electron. 602, 10 to the minus 19, times 10 to the minus 25. Wait, did I say minus 25 or plus 25 in the question? Minus 25. Okay. So that means the force is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 44 newtons. Very small force.
Okay.
Yeah, the question is, here you have a wire, you know wire? Yes. And there's a positive in the wire, so there's an electron here, E minus, and it will want to move away or towards? Into the wire, this way. So you can use the formula here to calculate the F, because you know this and you know this and you want this. Yeah. So this one here is charge of electron. No. This one here, charge of electron. This one here, I give you in the question. The E here is 10 to the minus 25 newtons per coulomb.
What's the blue line?
The blue line? That's the electric field. Yeah, remember in the picture you drew? It goes from positive to negative.
So what's the electron distance or direction? It's going down?
It's going down. Yeah. Well, it doesn't matter. I mean, I don't think I said. Yeah, I didn't say. I said a current running through in copper wire. So maybe, yeah, maybe it's negative in here. And if it's negative, then it will be pushed away. I didn't say. You're right, Sophie. I didn't say if it was positive or negative in the question. But I don't really care if it's positive or negative, because it doesn't change the force, it just changes the direction. So yeah, if it was negative, then it would be this way instead. Yeah. Okay, can I do the next one? Okay, write this one down. Yeah, let me clear up some things actually. So if you have positive here and negative here, the field, I draw this way, if I have a small positive charge, it will move in the direction of the field. But if I have a small negative charge, it will move opposite to the field. But the field always is drawn from the positive to the negative. So a positive will move with the field, but a negative will move away from the field in the opposite direction. Because the negative wants to be with the positive, and the positive wants to be with the negative. Is that okay, Sophie? Are you sure? You don't look happy.
So, negative is moving right?
This one is moving to the right, yeah. And the positive is moving to the left. But the field is always positive to negative. Mm-hmm. Okay, try this one. Did you write it down? Okay, let's have a look. So, you have here three protons. Proton, proton, proton. One, two, three. And here you have an electron. So, which way will this electron want to move? Towards the photons. And you have a field here. Well, negative electron will move to the positive photon, yeah. Now, you have F. Oh, by the way, I'm sorry to tell you this, but sometimes I use big Q and sometimes I use small Q. It depends how I feel. I haven't decided which I like more, big Q or small Q. So if I write small Q,
The charge,
yeah, but sometimes I use big Q and sometimes I use small Q. You might say, Stephen, please pick one. I can't. I can't pick one. I don't know which one I like more. Yes. What? The field is positive to negative always. Yes. Continue.
No.
So E equals F over Q.
The field.
Positive to negative, yes. Moves to positive. Would you notice? No, you're thinking, you're thinking too much. Stop thinking too much, okay? So look, if this is negative and this is positive, you know they want to move together. If this is positive and positive, away. Negative, negative, away. If this is positive and this is negative, there's a field from the positive to the negative. If this is positive and this one's negative, there's a field from the positive to the negative. But the field doesn't change the fact that if this is positive and this is negative, they want to go together.
Okay.
Electrons move to positive, yes. But you know this in chemistry. Because electron is negative and it likes positive. Yeah, okay. Continue. Yeah, like popcorn, yes. Okay, continue. So, do we know the E? What do I tell you the E was in the question? Yeah, the E.
1.41?
P? That's a Q. Oh, forget it. I'll go back to big Q.
No, she meant the proton.
Oh. Continue, Amanda. Times 10 power? 24 newtons per coulomb. Yes? Okay. Right. Do we know the Q? We do. Because it's electron. Yeah?
Yeah.
Do we know the E?
No. Yes.
So can we know the F?
Yes.
Yeah. So F equals QE. So F equals 1.602 times 10 to the minus 19 times 1.41 times 10 to the minus 24. So F equals 2.26 times 10 to the minus 43 newtons. Now, what do I ask you for in the question? What do I want? And what do I have? So, yeah. My friend Newton tells me F equals MA. So that means MA equals this. So the A will be this divided by the M. Do you know the mass of an electron?
Yes.
What's the mass of an electron? Let's write it in. Do you have it? 9.11 times 10 to the minus 31, is it? And you get a small 2.48 times 10 to the minus 13 meters per second squared. Minus 6 is micro, minus 9 is nano,
pico.
Minus 12 is
pico,
minus 15 is femto. So if you want, this would be 248 femtometers per second squared. All right, femto.
Mm-hmm.
Remember femto? Probably not.
It's
fine. You can stop here. That's fine. Do you remember? Micro is minus
6.
Nano?
Minus 9.
Pico?
9.
Femto?
15.
18. I don't know. I usually only need these two.
Remember this one?
No, goodness, no. You should only remember up to here. Yes? Explain what? Oh, everything. All right, okay. But no, not everything. Is it everything? Are you okay with this part?
Yeah.
This is okay?
Yeah. So
what?
Something,
no,
electron
moves
to proton.
Yes.
And there are electrons here going out.
Yes.
And
then I want to know what is the acceleration. So first I calculate the force. Then I use my friend Newton, and he tells me what the acceleration is.
Why did
I delete M? No, I didn't delete it. I bring it under. Because I want the A. Yeah. Another example.
More examples.
More examples is good. More examples is good. Okay, write this one now. More understanding. Okay. Okay. Not okay.
Milligrams,
correct. Continue. I will draw a beautiful picture. So here's my beautiful picture. What you have here, two plates. And here is the dust here. And the dust has a minus 100 electron charge. And this plate is positive. And this plate is negative. So which direction is the field? Is the field going up or is the field going down? The field is going down. And which way will the electron move? Well, it wants to go up. And also, there's a force going down. What force is pulling it down?
The weight.
The weight. And in the question, I say that it is balanced. Mm-hmm. So if it's balanced, then the forces are equal. Yep. So what's the mass of the electron? Well, that's 1 milligram. Which is 1 times 10 to the minus 3 grams, which is 1 times 10 to the minus 3 times 0.001 kilograms, which is 10 to the minus 6 kilograms. So what is the weight? This is W and this is F. So the weight will be 10 to the minus 6 multiplied by, 9.81. This is the force going down. Therefore, the force going up should equal the same thing. These must be the same. And you also know that E equals F over Q. So that means F must equal EQ. So what you can do is you can put that in here. And you get EQ equals 9.81 times 10 to the minus 6. So E equals 9.81 times 10 to the minus 6 over Q, which is 9.81 times 10 to the minus 6 over 100 times 1.602 times 10 to the minus 19. Which equals very big. Oh no, E? Electric field strength, yeah. 612 mega newtons per coulomb. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Thanks. I know! Yeah?
E.
Small e?
Yes.
1.602 tenths to the minus 19. In fact, it's on your calculator.
Please help me.
Which calculator? Oh, that's right. You have problems.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Who has this calculator? Does anyone have it? Sorry, do you have this one? Oh no. Do you have another?
The Amazon.
Amazon has it. Great for Amazon. So Amazon can do this question easily. No, not this one. So if you do get this calculator, I'll show you. Look at the lid. All the constants are on the calculator. So for example, you can see E is number 23. Look. You see E is number 23. So if I type in constant number 23, I get an E, and there's the number. So it's quicker, you know, you don't have to type it. So you see you have here mass of proton, mass of neutron, mass of electron, don't know what that is. Planck constant, don't know. And so you press shift 7, and then pick the constant you want. So for example, you see C0? That's actually the speed of light, 28. This is the speed of light. What else have we used in class? Oh yeah, in materials, the ideal gas law constant. Look here, look, 27. 8.31 for our ideal gas law. PV equals NRT. It's constant 27, you see?
It's
shift 7, and then the constant number.
But I don't get it.
This is a really good calculator. I'm trying to find this one. Now you see, interesting now. There it is there. You can write it down. Casio FX991ES12.
I know, I told you to email them, yes.
Oh, you know, in the exam they usually do the calculations using 1.602, but I'm very happy if you use your calculator mode to get the full number. It's more accurate technically. Okay. Continue?
Yes.
Yes, Mrs. Chinese. What? Right. Try this one. Then after this, you can work on your lab report. I can check what you have done, if you have done anything, or if you were just in Pitt Brothers for the whole weekend eating barbecue pig. Oh, I know it's good, but you still, you know, need to do your physics.
Is something?
Oh, I don't know. This sounds dangerous.
I'm on
I think it's easier to fix physics than to fix Amazon.
It's for a long time.
I know. Well, I know, I remember Amanda's problem with her laptop.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. Don't remind you. Yeah.
It is 2 months later, I got my calculator and I already finished my class.
Good, then you can give it to me, I'll use it.
You have one.
Ah, but I can have a spare one.
A new one?
A new, yeah, a cleaner one.
Okay.
copy?
No.
Yes?
No.
Friend. Do I like? Ah, it's okay. I don't really like Costa or Starbucks. I kind of like just small coffee shops. No. Not during school. No.
Small.
Let's see. I don't know. Noshington's is good, but it's too expensive, and I'm so poor, so I can't go there. Oh, everything is very good. Their cake, their coffee, all delicious. But unfortunately, I'm a teacher with not much money. Poor me, yes, poor me. I have to use 25-cent resistors and free coffee. Life is difficult. Yes. It's cheaper than going to Washington's every day. Okay. So what you have here is a proton, and here is an electron. And it's in the middle. Which way will the electron move? It won't move. So what's happening here is the electric field for the protons. But the point I want to make is it is possible for them to cancel. So do you see here there's an electric field going to the right, and there's an electric field going to the left, and they are equal and they are opposite. They're equal in size and they're opposite in direction, which means they cancel each other here. So you have no field. So that means no force, which means no movement. So again, it's like with the wind. If you have some wind blowing this way, and you have wind blowing this way, they can cancel, and you don't move. Okay. Here you go. Okay, just let me check here. Yes, okay. Can I stop the video just? No, I leave the video because you want me to explain for this one. Did you take a picture? Yeah. So if I just go back to this one. So what's happening here is that you kind of need to draw it in the middle. There's an electric field to the right from this one. And there's one to the left from this one. Yeah, and these are equal size, but opposite direction. So they combine and cancel. So this is why it doesn't move, because it's balanced. The two fields cancel. So my point I'm making is electric fields can cancel, or also they can add together to make a stronger field.